Right, so as you can see, I have the filament head tore apart to where the tensioner is. I was having issues. Nothing I did was getting the filament to press onto the plate good enough. And I kept adjusting Z. That wasn't doing it. And I finally decided to tear this apart because I didn't feel like I was getting my adjustment here to tighten on the filament. And as soon as I tore it apart, I noticed that this thumb thing was broke. So I did use a two-part epoxy to glue it back together. I still got to clean it up a little bit. But I'm actually not going to use that. I found one on, I believe it was Things Universe. So I've already got it on the Bambu. Luckily, I've got another printer. I've got the Bambu A1, so I've got some red PET G I'm going to print this one out on. And I found it, I don't know if I closed that tab or not already. It's on printables. Neptune 4 Max plus extruder tension arm. I'm pretty sure it's going to be the same as the Neptune 4 Pro. He says that this is a cult creation. This was, he says that it is more durable. So you can see how it goes in here. And mine broke on this pin right across. Well, it's this way. As far as I can tell, everything looks the same. So I'm going to print that out in a little bit out of, I think he used PLA. I'm not sure, but I'm going to use PET G. I'm going to make it red so it's kind of colorful. And we'll see how it goes and see if this fixes the issue, which I'm pretty sure it will. And I'm probably going to go ahead and print two of them out. But anyway, if you run into the problem to where nothing you do seems to get the lines right on your table, it could be that your filament's not being pressed onto the plate right. And if you're adjusting your Z-axis and it don't seem to be changing anything, then give your filament a tug and see if it's got enough tension on it. And if you adjust that set screw that's in the back of the head and you can't get it to tighten up anymore, more than likely this part here is broke. So just a heads up for all you Elegoo Neptune users. Okay, so here's the new part off of the Bambu A1. I'll have to break the trees off, but it looks like it should work. We'll find out shortly. this slides over that pin, and this has to go, this little nipple has to go in that spring. See if, just pull this pin out right here. I've already sprayed grease on them. So I was wondering how good these are going to fit in these hose. Top. All right, got a little frustrated with this because I had my pins backwards. The long pin goes up front. If you have it in this hole back here, you won't get this gear in there. So the long pin goes closest to the spring. The short pin holds the gear in. I know I slid that in, but the feeder that tightens on your filament goes to the bottom and the gears go up top, and then it will mate with the gear that's underneath this gear, and that's what turns that. But this went in there, everything fit good. I did hammer those pins in, they're a snug fit, and it looks like everything's going to work. There's also a picture on the website where I got this print STL file to print out. So if you get lost, you can look at that picture there. Okay, on this, if you remember, I was talking about the long pin being up here. You have to be sure you get that in the right position or you won't be able to get this plate here on flat. Took me a couple times. I finally got it perfect. And you can see I got the first screw in to hold this plate on. And that's just kind of loose because we're going to place this motor. The wires will go up top. I'm trying to do this with one hand. And then the screws will go through the motor, through the top plate, and into the housing. So as you can see, I've got the motor back in, this plate back on, these three screws on. But you can't forget, behind these wires is itsy bitsy screw that's going to go back in. And on this side here, there's a hole there. I don't know if you can see it or not, behind that wire. And there's a little bitty screw that goes up in there. And I mean, they are little bitty. You can see them right there in this lid. So two of those go in the sides. So don't forget to put, first you gotta take them out to even get this cover off, but don't forget to put them back in. Since you have this off, go ahead and get your little Allen wrench and tighten up both of these bolts that hold this hot end on. I have had one of these back out before and caused me all kinds of issues. So even if you change that boot out sometimes, or if you were replacing your nozzle, every now and then get your Allen wrench and go up in there and make sure those are tight. Because like I said, I did have one back out and it caused that to cock down and caused me all kinds of issues. I've already tightened those. Now I'm going to put my heat boot back on. I would just refer back to your install instructions when you put this head back on, but there's four screws. You have to put this cable holder back on, two screws there, and then there's two screws on either side of this bottom roller. And then we'll plug it back in, put our cable back in this clip. We're going to put the fan back on with three bolts. 1, 2, 3. And then we'll put our cover back on with the two bolts that go in the front. And then we'll be done. As you can see, this is there. We will adjust the tension on our filament so we can't pull it out. And then we'll run some parts and see how it works. So I got it all back together. And I'm fixing to re-level my table. Follow your instructions for that, because this was removed and put back on. You're going to want to re-level. Okay, we're doing an auto level. I leveled it manually first, and now we're doing the auto level. Okay, there's my first test strip after getting everything back together. Looks like everything is good to go. Getting a nice strip there. Now I'm gonna make a shelf and we'll see how it turns out. All because of this being broke, boy, it messed it up. All right, we've got that replaced. We did a bed level. Now we're doing a print. And as you can tell, it's coming out pretty doggone good. So as you can see, we've got both the printers printing little shelves. The shelves look like these that we found on Maker World. And this broke on Elegoo. So we used the Bambu A1 and some red PETG to make an upgraded part that we found on Printables. Thank you to the person who did that. We have his name in a picture in the video. It is built heavier duty, and I don't think we'll have any more issues. But I did go ahead and print out an extra one just in case that one breaks. We'll be good to go again. But as you can see by this print, it's printing really good. And it just took me a while to figure out that the reason I couldn't get my Z-axis right, I kept adjusting it up and down trying to get my lines right, and it just wasn't happening. I checked for clogs. I finally tore it apart and saw that this was broke. Not broke now. Printing like it should. If y'all like this video, be sure to hit the subscribe button while you're here, share with your friends, and give us a big thumbs up. Thanks.